Welcome back, everyone. My name is Joel Feld, and today is all about how to create a new Apple ID, or should I say Apple account. Here we go. I have three devices here. I have a Mac, I have an iPhone, and an iPad, and there's various stages of when you can create a new Apple account. It could be your very first Apple device. I just recently got one of the new iPad Pros with the M4 processor that will support all of the Apple intelligence. We can walk through the process to create an Apple account during the setup. And then I also have another phone here where we could do the same exact thing, but bypass all of the setup, go into the settings and create an Apple account that way. On the computer, we can go to Apple's website to create a new Apple account, or we can create one from the system settings. So amongst all three devices, it should demonstrate a good understanding of how to create an Apple account, when and where. So let's start with the new iPad. Just turned it on. The first thing it prompts us is our language. So I'll choose English, choose United States. We'll do the default appearance here. And then this option here, Quick Start, it's gonna look for other devices nearby that already have an existing Apple account signed in. I don't wanna set this new iPad up with an existing one, so I'm gonna choose Setup Without Another Device. It's gonna prompt me to get on the Wi-Fi. Type that in, choose Join. Data and Privacy, choose Continue, Setup for Myself. Now, if you were setting this up for your child, you can actually go through the process to create a child account for them. That'll be a different video. So we'll do Setup for Myself. Face ID, we'll do Setup Later. I don't need a passcode at the moment, so I'll do Don't Use Passcode. Yes, Don't Use. I'm not gonna do anything with iCloud or any backup whatsoever because I'm gonna pretend this iPad is brand new and I don't have any of that to begin with. So I will choose don't transfer anything. And this is where it will prompt me to either sign in with my existing Apple account or I'll choose forget password or don't have an account. I will touch that link. And this is where I can choose to create a free Apple account. So I'm gonna touch that in the center. And this is where it will prompt me for my first name, my last name, birth date, January. My kids think I'm old. 1985, 14th, continue. And this is where I have two options. I can either create a new Apple account with an existing personal email address. Maybe I have a Gmail account or Yahoo or MSN or Hotmail, anything like that. Or this link right here says don't have an email address. If I choose this, I can actually create a new email address from Apple that ends in @icloud.com. I really like their email system, so that's what I'm gonna do here. You don't necessarily always have to create an Apple account based off of a third-party email address. You can actually get your own email address from Apple, and this is how you do it. I'm gonna choose get an iCloud email address. And then touch in the email. And this is where I'm creating what that new email address is going to be. Now I'm gonna type in Joel Feld here and choose continue. And you're gonna notice it's gonna say, hey, this email address is already taken because it already exists. I already own that email address. So I'm gonna touch okay here. And this is where we need to type in something new that hopefully doesn't exist. So I'm just gonna do Joel Feld test 2024. And if this one exists, I don't know what to tell you. Let's choose continue. So now it says, okay, let's create Joel Feld test 2024 at iCloud.com and make sure that this is what it is because it's not going to allow you to change it after this. We'd have to create a brand new one. So I'm gonna choose create email address. It's going to prompt me to create a new password. So I will type in a password. Notice it does have to be 8 characters, include a number, an uppercase letter, and a lowercase letter. And then I will choose continue. So now it wants me to associate this Apple account with a telephone number to verify the identity that I'm a legit person. Type in 763-347-9916 and touch continue. And then on my phone here, I should get a text message. Yep, Apple account. Your Apple account code is 949704. Then it will prompt me for terms and conditions. You can read all of this fun stuff if you choose, but I'm gonna choose agree. So naturally, it's creating the account, and then because this is a brand new iPad, it's gonna put this into the system settings for this iPad. So I'll choose continue, sure, I'll turn on location devices, set up later, continue, share, that's fine. I like dark mode, huge fan of dark mode. Touch continue, Apple intelligence features, image playground, all of that fun stuff. I'll do that later, set that up later, get started. Okay, so now we're at the main screen here. If I navigate to the settings, wherever that may be, notice in the top left here, we have Joel Feld, and it's got that email address, joelfeld2024@icloud.com. So we've created a new Apple account. It signed it into the iPad. If I choose iCloud here, this is where I can choose what options I want to synchronize with iCloud. This iPad is now linked to that Apple account. So now let's do the same thing on an iPhone. This is the same place we were at with the iPad where we set up an account. Choose don't have an account, create a free Apple account, and the process literally is identical to the iPad. Let's take a step back. Let's pretend that I don't want to create that account right now. Maybe this is a device that's already gone through the setup process and I don't want to wipe it. So let's just do setup later in settings. And I'm going to say, yes, I don't want to use an Apple account right now. We'll agree to the terms and conditions. Yes, iPhone update automatically. Not now for iMessage and FaceTime. Turn on location services. We'll set up later for cellular. We're just going to set up later for all of this stuff here. I do like dark mode. Do continue. Set up later for Siri. And then swipe up to get started. So now, the main difference between the iPad and the iPhone, if I go into settings here, notice at the very top, Apple account, there's no account signed in. So on any Apple device, there's two main methods to create an Apple account. One from Apple's website, or the other method, the preferred method, is through the system settings like this. I'm gonna go to Apple's website and then explain the main difference between both methods. If I exit out of here and go to Safari, I'm going to type in appleid.apple.com and choose go. This website is where you can manage your security and payments and essentially your whole Apple account. Now, you'll notice when I come here, there's an option to sign in, but I need to create a new Apple account. So in the top right here, I'm going to touch the little triangle and then choose create your Apple account. Now, this process is actually identical on the computer. So if I open up Safari on the computer and do the same thing, appleid.apple.com, I'm not gonna sign in. I'm gonna choose create your Apple account in the top right. And literally, it's both the same process. So first name, last name, birth date, all of that. So the main difference from creating the Apple account on this website versus the system settings, on the website, it wants you to use an existing email address from a third-party company. So if you have something like Gmail, Hotmail, Yahoo, that's where you can type that current email address here to be used as your Apple account. As long as it's not an Apple account already, it can be used. So if I were to continue through this process here, it will be no different than what we did on the iPad. The only difference is if I create that account here, it's not going to automatically sign me into the settings. I have to do that step afterwards. So that's why I prefer not to use the website. I just go right into the settings under the Apple account options and create the account from here because it will sign me in directly afterwards. I'm going to choose don't have an Apple account. Do my first name, my last name. Now here's a fun fact. If you choose the birth date that is younger than 13 years old, it will actually prompt you. So let's just do 2020. Let's say that my birthday is November 26, 2020. If I choose continue, this is how you create a child Apple account. So it's now going to prompt me as the parent to sign in with my Apple account so that it will then be a child Apple account under my main Apple account. And you can have different screen time restrictions, monitor their activity and set time limits. It actually works really, really well. Now this option would have shown up on the iPad as well. In addition to the Mac, if you create it, it's all based upon the birth date that you enter in. So be honest to create a child account. Otherwise you can bypass that. So I'm gonna choose cancel on the top. We're gonna go back don't have an Apple account, type in my first name, type in my last name. I'll do my real birthday, January 1985. Choose continue. Invalid birthday. You know, here's my hunch. I think that if I create too many Apple accounts on one particular device, it doesn't let you. So I have another phone here. Let's go to the same exact spot. Let's open up settings, go to Apple account. Do you don't have an Apple account? Type in the birth date. I'm gonna, just for fun, try my actual birth date again, because I'm pretty sure it's tied to the device. When you do so much testing, we'll do continue. Haha, see, it let me in. Different device, older device. I'm gonna have to just keep on buying Apple products so I can do more test videos for testing Apple accounts. It's ridiculous. Okay, so back to the same exact spot. Notice it's identical to the iPad. It is literally identical. So don't have an email address. Yes, create an iCloud email account. We'll do Joel Feld test 2025. I don't want announcements. We'll do continue. Yes, create an email address. Create a password. Choose continue. Because this phone is activated with this telephone number, I have an option to verify my identity with either this telephone number or a different telephone number. I'll do continue here. Do agree. Perfect. Okay. This is what should normally happen. Just like the iPad, it's now signing me into the main settings of this iPhone with brand new iCloud account, 5 gigabytes, which is useless, honestly. It wants the passcode for the phone, so I'll type that in. And here we are in the settings, Joel Feld test 2025, iCloud.com. As you can see, the process for the iPhone literally is identical to the iPad. And honestly, if I open up system settings on the Mac, it's the same exact process. Open up system settings, click on sign in at the top, choose don't have an Apple account, and you're walking through the same thing. So I'm actually not gonna do that here because there's no need to. So what I will do instead is I'm going to sign in the one I just created here on the phone. So I'll type in Joel Feld test 2025 at iCloud.com, choose continue. Type in the password I just created, choose continue again. And because this is a trusted device now, because I signed into this phone with the same Apple account, notice it's saying, hey, your Apple account is being used on another device. Do you want to allow that device or don't allow? So I'm going to choose allow here on the iPhone, type in this code 231423, choose continue on the Mac. So now both this iPhone and this user account on this Mac are gonna start synchronizing with iCloud. So contacts, calendars, photographs, videos, the majority of everything I do on this iPhone has the opportunity to synchronize to this Mac. And I have lots of videos on iCloud. I love iCloud. The syncing capabilities, it's extremely convenient. I will post these videos here in the description below, so be sure to check those out. Now for fun, while this Mac signs in with the same Apple account, let's say that this iPad and the Mac and the iPhone, I want all to use the same Apple account, which naturally you do because it makes life easier. That way when you send a text message here, it's gonna show up on all of these other devices. So I'm gonna jump back to this iPad, and we're still in the settings here. I'm gonna scroll down and choose sign out, type in the password and choose turn off in the top right. I wanna disassociate this iPad from that Apple account. I don't wanna keep any of the data on it. So I'll choose sign out again. And I'm going to re-sign in with the Apple account that I created on the phone. So I'll touch Apple account. If I say use another Apple device nearby, if I bring my phone nearby, notice it says sign into the iPad, use your Joel Feld test 2025 to sign into this iPad. So I'm gonna say, sure, let's do it. Let's get started. And now it pops up this crazy little nebula stargazer thing. And on my phone here, it's got the option to scan it. So I'm gonna position that right there. And this is a very easy way to essentially set up this new Apple device with credentials that I already have set up on an existing device. Choose yes, set up for me. Notice on the iPad, it's being signed in with. Same exact account. Notice Joel Feld Test 2025 is being used. On the iPad, it says, enjoy your iPad here. On my phone, I'll touch done. So now both of these are synchronizing. Notice on the iPhone, it says, hey, there's another device being used with the same Apple account. I'll choose okay. So notice here on the Mac, it wants the password for the local account on the Mac. I'll do continue. And then it wants the passcode for the iPhone. So type that in, choose continue. So now on the computer, Joel Feld Test 2025 at iCloud.com. On the phone, same account. And on the iPad, same account. So naturally, this is how you would want everything to be set up. Notice device added to your account. I'll touch OK on the phone and the iPad. And here's one thing that's also helpful. When you're using the same Apple account, it's always nice to know what devices you're actually signed in. So notice here on the phone, if I scroll down, I can see that this iPhone, an iPad, and this MacBook 16-inch Pro here. Same thing on the iPad. Let's refresh this. Let's go to someplace else and go back to Apple account. There we go. Same three devices. And on the computer here, notice it's got the same three devices. This will always show you what devices are currently signed in with this Apple account. In the grand scheme of things, that is how you create a new Apple account, whether you're on an iPhone, iPad, or Mac. You can see the similarities. It's pretty much identical across the board. It's just a matter of, do you want to use an existing third-party account, email address as your Apple account, or do you want to create a new Apple account with an iCloud email address from Apple? And depending on which you want to do is up to you, but that is how you create a new Apple account. So thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed what you saw, go ahead, hit that like button. If this video was helpful, certainly share it with your friends and neighbors. And if you want to support this channel, hit that thanks button below as well. So thank you so much. And we'll see you next time.